Let's build a Keezer. Today I'm going to show you how I built my Keezer. Before I get into the build, let's talk about what a Keezer is and why you'd want to build one. A Keezer is a chest freezer converted into a refrigerator that dispenses draft beverages. It's basically a DIY kegerator that homebrewers can design and modify to meet their draft beer needs. If you're thinking about ditching bottling beer for a draft system, a Keezer is a great cost-effective option compared to buying a kegerator. I built my Keezer system with all new components, including the freezer, the tap system, the temperature controller, and all the accessories for around $500. I'm sure you can build this for less if you look for deals and used options. For me, this was well worth the price of not having to bottle beer. Check out the description below for all the components I used for this build. Let's first start by going over all the components. Then I'll go over how I built the collar for the tap system. I'll go into how I built the DIY temperature controller that actually converted the freezer into a refrigerator. And then I'll wrap up on how I added the CO2 system to this Keezer. At the heart of my Keezer is a 7 cubic inch freezer that can hold 3 kegs. I purchased this freezer for around $200. One feature I really like about this chest freezer is that it has caster wheels installed, making it easy to move around my garage. I used an Inkbird ITC1000 to control Keezer temperatures. This unit requires assembly before use. If you don't want the hassle of wiring a temperature controller, you can always buy this plug-and-play Inkbird for around 30 or 40 bucks. This is the project box for the temperature controller. It's 8x4x3 inches and will house the controller and a power outlet for the freezer and internal fan that circulates cold air. I plan on mounting the box on the outside so I can easily monitor the Keezer temperatures. Here's a project cable I will use to power the Keezer. I picked up plastic wire collars to tighten the power cords on the project box. I plan on using 2 taps for this Keezer. Each one of these taps cost around 40 bucks. 2 features I really like about these taps are 1, that they are spring-loaded and automatically close when the handle is released, and 2, they have a shutoff valve on the side to shut off the beer flow when not in use. This is a cooling fan I plan on installing inside the Keezer. I'll wire this fan to turn on when the Keezer kicks on to circulate cold air throughout the Keezer. And finally, I'm going to use silicone caulk to attach the wooden collar to the Keezer.
I'm gonna pop off these hinges. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna pop these screws off with a drill, and we're gonna take the top off and measure for the collar. Now that we have it unboxed, let's do a quick test fit of where the Keezer will be in my garage. So now we're going to measure the top of it. We're going to cut up our 2x8s, and we're going to build this collar.
After the boards were cut to size, it was just a matter of aligning the cut boards on top of the Keezer and making sure all the edges were level. I used a clamp to keep the boards together while I marked all the hole locations and screwed together the boards with 2.5 inch wood screws.
My next step is to find some wood screws and get this mounted. I have it mocked up for now. I have 2 screws in the bottom. Let's give it a shot to see if it opens. It should. Excellent.
Once I felt good about how the collar was mounted on the Keezer, I sanded down the wood boards and edges with fine grit sandpaper. After I was done sanding, I drilled 2 holes for the beer taps. I believe I used a 5/8 inch drill bit. Once I was done cutting the hole, I added a beer tap for a test fit. And for the mandatory test pour, I'm happy with the fitment.
I have 1 mounted. Tap opens just the way it's supposed to. We have another tap ready to go. I'm not going to install that. I think that's going to work out just fine. We're going to move on, sand this collar down one more time, and put a coat of stain on it.
I applied 2 quick coats of oak stain to dress up the wood a little bit, and then applied a gloss polyurethane to protect the wood from spills and moisture. Once the polyurethane dried, I coated the top of the freezer with a thick bead of silicone caulk. aligned the corners, and placed a weight on top while the caulk dried. Moving on to the temperature control box. This was the most difficult part of the build, but it really wasn't that bad. I started by cutting holes in the project box for the Inkbird controller and the outlet that will power the Keezer and fan. It was just a matter of marking the hole locations, drilling a few pilot holes, and then carefully cutting the openings with a jigsaw. I'm not an electrician. This part of the video is for informational purposes only. Refer to the Inkbird website for official installation instructions and check your local electrical code before taking on a wiring project like this. This is how I wired my temperature controller. I have the power source going into my project box and I tied together my neutrals, my hot leads, and grounds. I have one white wire in my hot leads, but I marked it black to indicate it is a hot lead. I took one hot lead and one neutral and tied it into one and two. This powers the unit. I'll use 3 and 4 for my temperature sensor, and 7 and 8 to switch the outlet. I have one hot lead going into the 7 and 8 relay, one neutral going into one side of the outlet, and one ground going into the bottom of the outlet. When the temperature sensor senses the freezer is getting too warm, it switches 7 and 8, sending power to the hot side of the outlet, completing the circuit, turning on the freezer and the internal fan. I fished the sensor wire into my Keezer through a hole in the side of the wooden collar. I ran the sensor into a bottle of water and sealed the bottle with hot glue. This bottle with the sensor just sits at the bottom of my Keezer. I ran my fan wire through the back of the Keezer and then mounted it directly to the wooden collar. And finally, here's a look at my CO2 tank, regulator, and lines. I have a double gauge Kegco regulator that can support 2 kegs. All I had to do was connect the CO2 lines to the regulator and then to the kegs. Once carbonated, beer lines are connected from the output keg connections to the taps. So that's a wrap on my Kegerator build. It was a really fun project. I do plan on making some modifications in the future that include moving the CO2 tank to the outside and also adding individual pressure regulators to the kegs to better control CO2 levels. Consider subscribing and giving me a thumbs up if you find this information helpful. If you haven't seen other videos I've uploaded recently, click here. I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.